everyone, it's George and welcome back to Call of Dragons. As dedicated free-to-play player who played this game for more than 400 days, I'm excited to share some insider tips and tricks with you. Stick around and let's dive in. Today is an amazing day because we have finally got the best update which I have seen in Call of Dragons. There is a lot of things which I want to uncover and which I want to speak about because these changes will be really really impactful for the future gameplay and right now. There is a couple of things which make this game easier because there were like a couple of interface changes, interface fixes, and also some new items, some new buildings, and some new gems gathering things. And as a free-to-play player, everybody wants to have more gems in the game, especially free-to-play players, right? So let's start from one by one and let's start with the new artifact which we can get from the normal keys from the artifact compendium. And generally whenever new artifact comes out and you can already get it from the normal pools, that's already amazing, right? New artifact is called Mana Stone Hunter. It's an all-arounder, which means every single legion type hero can hold it. And it's like in terms of attributes, Legion March Speed and Legion HP. Well, it already says that this artifact is not about fighting, it's not about gathering. It's kind of utility artifact because Legion March Speed and Legion HP, it does not sound like a fighting artifact. What's the most interesting about Mana Stone Hunter is the skill which we're gonna read right now. After a short charge up, creates a mana stone at a random location near the legion. With a 5% chance of creating legendary mana stone, this mana stone can only be gathered by the legions that can create it, and it will disappear after 10 minutes. I think this is a pretty unique artifact which we have never seen something like this, and whenever we have unique things in Call of Dragons, everybody likes it, and I myself included. Of course, it will be useful for every single player who are playing Call of Dragons. Does not matter if you are pay to win player or free to play player, mana stones are really really important thing in this game, especially whenever you are having war. Maybe you're gonna dig up and you're gonna get attack, HP or defense mana stone, or you want to have something like gathering speed, legion training speed, or like construction or research, right? You won't gonna be need to wait for the acolytes to spawn. You simply gonna get the mana stone from the artifact. Well, I think like cooldown 24 hours is like pretty long if you ask me, but simply because it's unique, simply because we have not seen anything like this before, I think I totally agree something like this will be really really helpful for the future of the game. And if we're gonna get more artifacts which are unique and which does not look like anything else which we have seen before, I am all about it, right? So at first, of course, I want to try it myself, how many bad mana stones this mana stone navigator will spawn, or maybe it will spawn only good ones, right? We're gonna see it, but simply because we can pull it from the normal pools, I already like it. So more artifacts for free to play players, more happy I will be in this game. This all for the new artifact. Of course, there is like second artifact which we will come out pretty soon, but I can't see it in the game, so it's really hard for me to speak about it, right? The second update is about the hospital, and I have been asking for this kind of update for a really really long time, and I will tell you why, right? For example, myself, I'm a marksman main, and generally whenever there is a war, I'm only fighting with my three marksman march and one mage march, which means whenever you are fighting more severely wounded troops, you are getting is marksman, like if you ask me, in my case, or mages, right? But sometimes you are farming darklings, you are farming forts, so you can have like some infantry, wounded troops, some cavalry, and a lot of marksmen and a lot of mages, right? With these clicks, you can prioritize which kind of units you want to heal at first, so it's really useful, right? Before, you had to like click manually how many units you wanted to heal. You are trying your best to heal only marksmen in my case, because I was fighting only with marksmen troops. So in this case, they made it a lot more easy. easier, and I like it a lot, right? Like, it, everything what's gonna make play this game easier, it will be amazing for this game and future of this game. Of course, in addition, for the beginners, it will be easier for them to understand how in general hospital works. And of course, as we know, resource healing got way less in terms of like resources spent for the resource healing, and of course there is like a couple of more changes in terms of hospital, right? Like, for example, when your legion and legions are defending against the enemy in your city or in alliance member cities, 10% of your severely wounded units will die, and 35% of enemy severely units will die. Now, when legions are defending against enemy attacking in alliance building or pass, 35% of your severely units will die, and 50% of your enemy severely wounded units will die. So, like, there is like different kind of percentages, which was before, which is a newest thing in this game. But at first, of course, we need to try it ourselves, and we're gonna discuss how it will affect the game. Capacity. There is no limit to capacity of your shaman hunt. Healing. Severely wounded units can be healed by selected either elixir healing or resource healing. I think this kind of typing discussion, which we can see here, is new, and like, it's especially good for the beginners because they will understand how hospital works by reading this one marker, which is saying every single detail which is important to know about hospital. That's the update for the hospital, which is pretty crucial in my opinion. You might not even understand how crucial it is, but if you are the maining one legion type in this game, it means that you are 100% liking the hospital update, right? I think the most important update in this game, which happened in this update, is about Bazaar, right? Bazaar is a new building, which is very unique, and which is one of the best things which we have had in Call of Dragons since the beginning of the game. So let's discuss what kind of new things this Bazaar is giving us, right? For example, first of all, we need to say that you can buy resources for Warped tokens. Like, for example, if I want to buy 5 million gold, I need to spend 100 tokens of the resource, like Warped tokens, right? Not only gold, like, you can buy 5 million wood, you can buy 5 million ore, and you can buy 5 million mana, and just because mana is like most important resource in the game, you need to spend 600 Warped tokens. I think this is pretty epic, right? 5 million wood for the 100 Warped token is pretty good ratio, if you ask me, because it's not really hard to get 100 tokens, Warped tokens, because if you have like upgraded Warped warrants, you can catch 6 pets per day. And if you're simply gonna like sell at least 3 or 4 pets daily, you will have more than 100 tokens for sure, which means that only from the Warped selling skills, you're gonna get, depending which kind of skill, which kind of resource you want to have, maybe it's ore, maybe it's wood, maybe it's gold, so everything depends on you. And of course, I totally agree that mana should be higher price. I don't know if it should be like 600 or maybe 400 or 500, but like, more longer this game will continue, more updates the developers of the games will have, and maybe they will lower the mana cost for this 5 million mana. But for sure, extra ways of getting resources, which means you won't gonna spend too much time farming, and you will have more time for fighting, right? So I really really enjoy this new update, this new Bazaar system, where you can simply just buy more resources for the tokens, because tokens generally, you can get tokens by simply playing the game in a natural way. What's most important about the Bazaar is that you can get some gems. So let's discuss about the gems and the resources, right? For example, for 5 million gold, you can get 100 gems. For 5 million wood, you can get 100 gems. And same, 5 million ore, you can get 100 gems. Of course, for 5 million mana, you're gonna get 600 gems. And let's say I spent like 5 million each resources, I'm gonna get 2000 gems. So come on, guys, like,
it's amazing, right? Nobody was expecting to have such a ratio. I did not expect that I would get a 100 gem even for 5 million gold, because I think gold, people have way much more gold, way much more wood than, for example, ore or mana. Like in my case, only surplus I had in terms of resources was my ore and sometimes my mana, right? So if you have lot amount of mana, lot amount of gold, I'm sorry, and wood, simply you can get, like, let's say you are not, like, simply you can have like 600 gems by just spending wood and gold, because I'm pretty sure everybody has like lot of wood and gold in their storages. So like 15 million gold, 15 million of mana, 50 million wood for like 600 gems, it will be useful for a free-to-play players. And also simply because that if you are a free-to-play player like me and you are making some research, you are not spending gems on the finishing of the research. You need to wait for like 20 days, 25 days, 30 days, so you have enough time to farm more, and you have enough time to get more resources for the future upgrades. So you will have, I'm pretty sure you will have enough resources to get gems from this resource, from this bazaar, right? So I think I really approve this kind of change. As I have said before, like, more gems you can get in this game as a free-to-play player, it's much better. It becomes way free-to-play friendly game than it was before, because from like before we had only events where we could get gems and gathering, which we could gather 1000 gems per week. And right now we have another way, so we already have three ways of getting gems by simply just playing the game, right? So I really like this kind of change in this game. In terms of war pets, we have like pretty amazing changes for the war pets, and we're gonna like try to understand one by one what kind of changes we are having here, right? Of course, we're gonna go to the war pet skill card collection, and whenever you're gonna click on the skill card from this page, you can actually sell your skill of the war pet, or you can use it on the war pet, which you can attach like from here, which was not doable in the past, and after this update you can actually do it. In terms of quick update, I have one question in terms of this quick update, because of course I can select the war pet to consume this war pet and this skill, but it says that we need like 10 poison glands in order for me to upgrade to 2-star, which is I'm not sure if that's a correct number, because whenever you are going from the pet side and I want to, for example, upgrade my Shadow Hunter, and I'm gonna click on upgrade, I need just 4 in order for me to upgrade to 2-star, right? So it's kind of, maybe it's just a type mistake, or maybe like if I'm gonna upgrade to 0-star, yeah, like if I want to upgrade 0-star to 1-star, it says I need to have 10 like advanced Counter-Strike. Maybe it's just the wrong number and they will fix it, but the update is about that we can update the skills of the stars from the Warped skill cards collection, right? So before, this kind of place was only for us to see how many skills we had, or maybe we could like simply just buy more space, and after this update we have 100 more space for the skill cards. So guys, you will be able to storage your warped skills much easier than before. So like another free warped slots which we can get, which will be useful for the future, because nobody wants to spend gems for the space of the skills, right? Of course, we didn't have any more free warped slots, which I was kind of expecting, but that's fine. If you want to have more slots for your warped, you have to spend 300 gems, and like 300 gems, that's not a lot, right? So like this is like warped changes which we are having here. Of course, like main difference is that we can actually spend warped tokens for resources in this game. And of course, one more change in terms of warped is that in Merit Store, you can actually have like talent skills more often than before. So like in general, before this update, I didn't have any pain bloom here, and after the update, I got 0-star pain bloom. So there is a chance that you're gonna get talent skill at least 1-star in the future, maybe even 2-star if you will get super lucky. So that's like the another way of making your warped building process much easier and much better. So like I'm all about all this free stuff, because Merit Shop and Merit Store is free for me, because if you are simply playing the game, you are fighting, of course, so you are not farming, only farming. You will have merits in this game, and the merits are free in my opinion. You are not spending anything, you are just getting merits by just playing the game. So I think this is like generally free stuff for players in general. Another update which we are seeing now from this update is about flying units, right? For example, for the Wyverns, we got a new skill, can destroy buildings from a long distance, only takes effect when your legion is composed entirely of Wyvern riders. And I think this is perfect, right? Before, flying units had no purpose in terms of like buildings, constructions, or destroying the buildings. Right now, if you can destroy the buildings from a long distance, it means that you have a lot more use than before, right? It means you don't have to move closer to the construction. You will be from the range throwing some bombs, and you will see how quickly it will destroy it. So it means that defending got harder and attacking got way easier, simply because in general, I think in the past, defending in Call of Dragons was 10 times easier than attacking, right? Like even if your alliance was like much stronger, if enemy knew how to defend, it was sometimes almost impossible to defend, because turrets, keeps, couple of keeps, lot of towers, lot of legions nearby. Even if you are stronger as an alliance, it's like simply just too hard to just push and too hard to just destroy so many constructions and so many buildings of the enemy alliance. Another update in terms of troops is, of course, finally marksmen got march speed increased, right? 145. Like, how you can see that marksmen got march speed increase? Well, it's pretty simple. We have finally more march speed than mages. Mages has 137, marksman has 145, same for wyverns, and of course we won't gonna have more march speed than cavalry, right, than the infantry. So I like this change. Of course, this change is connected to the removal of long range warfare, which is gonna happen in the next season. So if you are removing long range warfare, if you are removing the same range as mages for marksmen, you have to give them some kind of buff, because they will feel that like a lot of players turn to the marksman mains after the long range warfare. And if we're gonna remove the range, if we're gonna remove the playability of the marksmen, we have to give them some kind of buffs, right? And I think march speed buff is perfect, because that's all I have been asking. It's really impossible to move around the battlefield as a marksman, because you are just too slow, right? Everybody is catching you, infantry is catching you, of course cavalry will catch you, and even mages was going to catch you with the longer range than you. So I really appreciate this kind of buff. It will be really useful. I would like to have at least 150, but let's keep it at 145, and let's see how impactful this kind of change will be for the marksmen in the future. Overall, I think this is a great update, and like a lot of gameplay updates, a lot of UI updates. Like I really like hospital update. I really like the uniqueness of the new artifact. Of course, we are soon going to get new cavalry heroes, and simply by just seeing the talents of those two cavalry heroes, I think they will be OP. I really appreciate the flying units update, because they are finally getting some more buffs, some more uniqueness. It will be pretty epic that we can actually use our flying units to destroy enemy constructions. So that's another plus. And yeah, like Bazaar, I wasn't expecting testing something like this before in this game, and I think it will help a lot free-to-play players. I have never seen such a great addition to the game, especially for free-to-play players, because finally we will have another way of how to get gems in this game, and like everybody who is playing as a free-to-play player in Call of Dragons would agree that getting gems in this game is more satisfying thing than anything else, because you can spend it on Wheel of Destiny, you can spend it on Artifact Compendium, you can spend it on Lucky Spins, and what you want as a free-to-play player to have as much legendary heroes as possible, because you don't want to fall back and you don't want to just have only like a couple of legendary heroes which you are playing, because at the end of the day it will be boring for you. And of course every single update which upgrade which the construction needs to get to level 25 needs some gems because of the master's blueprints, and it will be helpful for everybody who wants to upgrade those buildings to 25, because it needs like 2,000 gems to do that, right? I hope you like the update. If you did, like, share your opinion in comment section, and if you liked the video, press like, subscribe, share. It always gives me more and more motivation to make more videos for this amazing game. I hope everybody's having an amazing day, morning or night, wherever you are. We are going to see each other very, very soon. Bye bye and good luck.